A lot of people think that the Airbus was actually invented in Europe. Bull. First one was built right here in the good old US of A. And like most hot rodders out there, they have grand schemes, big ideas, they never get off the ground, or at least not much higher than this Airbus has. Well, what's more dangerous than an American with a grand scheme and a bit of money? Got to be an Aussie. Well, Rod Hatfield is one crazy, super talented rodder out of Castlemaine, Australia. And for a living, he did left-hand to right-hand conversions, built some great hot rods over the years, manufactured a bunch of parts, but he had a dream 15 years ago to build the craziest 55 Chevy on the planet. 1650-inch supercharged Rolls-Royce Merlin engine making 3,000 horsepower. The first thing he did is he chopped out the firewall out of a virgin 55 Chevy and said, there, now I'm committed. Then he put the Merlin motor underneath the body and realized, holy cow, this thing is going to take a serious frame. Well, it took 5 years full-time, one fabricator, just to build the frame for this car. It took another 9 months of painting. Each one of those rivets is hand painting. The guy's just getting out of the insane asylum now, painting this car, and then it took about another 6 months to actually get the car to drive down the road. Well, I can't do a traditional drive. The owner's standing off camera here. He's got a gun pointed at me.
Don't break my stuff.
Well, at Legendary, we can fix just about anything, but I don't know about this. So this drive here is going to be non-traditional. I'm not going to stand on it. You're not going to see a great big burnout, but I get the feeling it's going to be the most intimidating thing I've ever driven.
Well, here's the start procedure, and it's like starting a plane, so hopefully I don't screw this up. First, we have to turn on the main battery switch. Then we drop down, we open up the oil tank. The next thing we have to do is turn on the fuel and the ignition. We have to run the magneto switches both up, pull out the fuel mixture all the way out, and at the same time, I'm going to push the start, the coil boost, and this little button here.
The little bit I'm getting to drive this car just opens the window a tiny bit into the power one of these engines makes. It wants to turn the car over, not just propel it forward. With the body removed, you can see the physical size of the engine is staggering. Now, it's one thing to shoehorn in an engine, it's another to engineer it so it works. Check out the custom step-up box between the engine and the Lenco transmission. The frame is a work of art in its own right. Well, what's something like this worth? Only what the next nutcase will pay for it. Now, what would it cost to build something like this? Way over $1 million, and I don't even know if you could duplicate it for this. The quality of this car is unbelievable. The outrageousness of this car, I don't think you're ever going to see again.